We're going to be showing you four or five different cuts. Beautiful Scotch lamb, bit of salt and pepper, as nature intended, it's fantastic. And I know I'm starting off with this great product. We leave ours hanging for a week to 10 days before it hits the counter. That tells them the eating quality for the customer. There's so many butchers there, there's so many places where you can buy Scotch lamb, so it has to be perfect when it leaves my shop to go to your table.
You leave that, you need to leave a piece of meat that size before you roast it for about an hour, just in at the room temperature. Cover it over the cloth to stop the flies getting at it, or a wee mesh or something of that sort, but it must get up to room temperature. Please don't cook a beautiful piece of meat like that straight from the fridge.
But what I always recommend is, we would take this, pop it back in, roast it as it is. When you're finished, take it back out, give it to the dog. Ideal. And you've maximised the flavour that you can get from that. So where you would eventually buy your meat from, even in a restaurant, if you see Scotch lamb, the welfare standards are all so high.
And that's the thing as well with lamb, I think it's important to point out, Christopher, people will quite happily have the ribeye steak or whatever, medium or medium rare. Perfectly safe to do that with Scotch lamb, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Ladies and gentlemen, Joyce is just passing round the first of the samples which Christopher's cooked up.
So that's the richness of the lamb, and it's cleaned up with that salsa. It's a great barbecue dish. You can make the salsa in the morning, leave it in the fridge, no problem at all. Have your steaks just piled up in the garden, cover over in the cloth, and then when you're ready to barbecue, glass of wine in hand, and away you go, and plonk the salsa on top. Couldn't be easier. It's a really, really simple thing to do.
Gentlemen, we're just going to have a word with some of our samplers here to see what they're thinking of the lamb that you've so beautifully prepared and cooked. Madam, you've been sitting for ages. What are you thinking?
It's lovely.
Do you normally eat lamb?
Yes.
Good. Someone who supports our industry. You know, raise our livestock to the highest possible we can. And we really appreciate it that butchers and chefs then treat it with that same respect and have a meal which this lady can enjoy is absolutely fabulous. And because the Scottish sheep industry is so stratified, that we're all the different breeds, we're being seasonal all year round. We've just said that's you finishing last season, starting this season. So you can have it in season Scotch lamb all year round.
Yeah, I'm just going to season these bits of meat up, a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper. Only add that just before you cook it. Never salt anything too early, otherwise the salt will dry the moisture out and you'll get a wet piece of meat, and you don't want that.
How important hill sheep and lowland sheep are to all the different parts of Scotland. So in a few minutes, ladies and gentlemen, we'll have some delicious samples. I think Alan's looking a bit as if he's nearly ready. Are you, Alan?
You're ready.
Who needs Bisto when you can make your own stock that colour? And all I've done is cook a piece of meat.
I said he's finished.
Some red wine.
The pan, Christopher, not for you.
Yeah. So there goes the rope. Can you smell that red wine? Isn't that fantastic? And we'll rest it. And whilst it's resting, I'm going to make a sauce with the chopped shallots. You could use onions if you want to. This gives it a lovely savoury flavour.
And this is pencil of lamb this time. Remember, if you were here earlier, you saw the bit that Stuart cooked. He said this was the best bit, so it's probably worth the wait. Well, that's the quickest way, and we don't have a lot of time today. And Stuart's making a fantastic job of butchering it up for you so that it's ready for you to cook quickly and easily.
But it's just echoing what you're saying. We make sure we utilise as much of the animal as possible.
A little bit of seasoning, so it's coloured, look at that lovely caramelisation, colour on both sides, and then I'll just let it cook for a little bit longer.
It's good. That's fantastic.
That's good.